Really? It didn't give me any recovery? At least I saved. I doubt I'm gonna be able to kill him with fucking no health. Peril. So long, King Bowser. Yeah, it's not that easy, I'm afraid. That was just a mini fight. Really? You're not gonna heal me at all? There's gotta be a heal somewhere between then and now. Well, if I die, then I'll know I have to heal before this fight with items, which is stupid. He's got a Kami Koopa boost with the Star Rod boost. I'll most likely die just because I didn't know I wouldn't be healed, which is kind of ludicrous to me. I think they would have given you some sort of a heal before the final fight. Oh no. Go get him, Twink. Twink's getting stronger. He's getting angry. Oh my, how the tables have turned. Dusted. Kind of reminds me of giving Goku the energy for the spirit bombs, kind of the same concept of what we're doing right here. Healed. All right, let's fucking do this. peach bean. Does a fuckload of damage. 99 health, huh? That's a lot. Oh. And all you got? Oh no, my little buddy. I wonder if he gets to retain his power. If not, that sucks. No, I don't think he retains his power if he gets hit. Okay, that's gonna make things a little bit more difficult. I wish I would have known that you don't keep your charges if you fucking get hit by the star rod. Yeah, major waste of turns. So now I gotta pull something out of my asshole in order to win this fight without charges. It's like what my one shard technique's been taken away from me. What a dickhead. Not giving up. I think we got this, possibly. I wanted to save that for the Super Saiyan guy. He's gonna be a whole hell of a lot harder without that. Oh my god, he can heal with the Star Rod. Oh my god. Yep, here we go. I'm gonna try to get one more charge out of my Umbario in the hopes that he doesn't use the Star Rod against me. No, it's like he knows. This is most likely gonna take two shots, but that's okay. I learned a lot of things I didn't know. I should have just taken the wipe and started over now that I understand a few things. Will be the end right here. Sorry. Let's try that again, now that I know the rules. I never said doing this with just the hammer was going to be easy. If I could use my jump, I could probably kill him in 4 turns, but I took out my most powerful thing. I did it on purpose. This time I'm gonna stick to 2 charge turns instead of 3. I don't even remember what I fucking did last time. What the fuck did I even do last time? Well, I could have, but it heals me right now after, so I didn't want to waste any items on being healed, and there was no box to heal myself. I guess what I could have done, though, not to waste that one revive shroom, is I probably could have just smooched, because I don't think, or I think it would have healed my star power, too, for the fight. Which, if I die, I'll make sure to do that next time. All right, try this again. Like I said, I'm gonna do two charges and that's gonna be the max. Seeing as how at any time he can just fucking knock my fucking partner on his fucking feet. Nice. Nice. I'm lucky as fuck here. Ah. Did I really just beat him? I didn't think I just did 99 health that quick. Yeah, I did. I beat him. Holy shit. Fuck yeah. I can't believe I did 99 damage that fast. Game's not over yet. I said that the game wasn't over completely beat until I beat Super Saiyan Dojo Master. This is actually the music in Super Mario 3 when you're falling down from the castle after you beat the ship. Now, this game really is amazing though. You get to see everything as part of the Mario universe, the Shy Guys. You know, and what's cool is your partners. You basically get one partner from each, like, race of Mario characters that you would normally see. So that was cool, too. Thought the bosses were well thought out. Whole game was well thought out. I like the badge system a lot. I did. I beat the hell out of this game. Well, I haven't necessarily beat it yet, because I haven't beat the Super Saiyan Dojo Master. But I'm going right next to him. It's not GG till I beat the Super Saiyan Dojo Master. Thank you. Oh, so that's it, huh? That's how you took the Star Rod back from Bowser. It seems like another wild adventure is in the books, bro. The castle's back in its normal place, and now everyone's returned home safely. You came through in the end, just like you always do. I know you've been back for days now, but I'll bet you still kind of feel like you're on an adventure, don't you? That reminds me, the pals who traveled with you, I wonder what they're up to now. Hey, it's Chris and Emily.
Thank you.
You know, they always talk about Princess Peach, but you don't ever see who the king and queen are. Always wondered that. Yeah, I mean, no doubt, it's the end of the game, but, there's, a guy you can fight in this game, and I'm pretty sure after this parade I can, pretty sure it takes me right back to Toad Town. If it takes me back to Bowser's Castle, that would suck, because there'd be no easy way for me to get back, unfortunately. I thought I brought you back to Toad Town. If not, at least I can say I beat the game with hammers only. Pretty cool. But either way, true to my word, I will definitely try to get a GameCube emulator up and running tomorrow, and I'll start a run of the Thousand Year Door, which will be exciting. I'll try to do it with no guide, seeing as how I've never even played it before, but if I get stuck, I get stuck. I might have to use a guide. Looks like Mario's gonna go get a little of the in-out. No, I've beaten this game a few times. Like literally maybe two or three times once I was a kid. I think I tried to do a playthrough like 4 or 5 years ago. Now what would be cool is if someone could pull off a no partners run where you don't use your partners at all, which other than, you know, moving around and completing out of battle stuff, but I wonder if it's even possible to do that in battle. Look at that emulator freaking out. Thank you. Yeah, I've also noticed too that I think it just sits. I don't think this is endless. I'm waiting to see if it stops. If not, I'll just end the stream, but I'm gonna give it some time because I think it does basically end and go back to the main menu. I've tried hitting all the buttons and I can't progress past this. But yeah, I find that the N64 emulator is probably the most unstable emulator out of all the emulators. I don't know why that is. I think it just has something to do with the way the N64 renders graphics and something that the computer can't do that the N64 can, maybe, I don't know. Does this really just sit here endlessly? I could have swore it would save and go back to the main menu. Don't think I've ever seen a game that sits on the end screen with no way to go back to the game menu. Where they just expect their kids to turn the friggin' Nintendo off? Looks like I won't be able to fight the Super Saiyan Dojo guy, but definitely, if you guys wonder about that, go take a look at it. It's a pretty fun fight. The dude's about as strong, if not stronger, than King Bowser. I wish I could fight him, but I don't know if it's possible to even leave the castle. And if it would take so long for me to backtrack just to do that one thing. But yeah, look forward to the Thousand Year Door. Thanks for watching.
If you like my content, please consider giving it a like. If you want to see more, make sure you hit subscribe and click that bell notification so you don't miss out.